In this video, I will show you the difference between declaring variables with let and var. Let's start with the first of three differences, scope. When it comes to scope, that means where is my variable valid? Var is not block scoped, meaning that it exists also outside of the statement where it was created. On the other hand, let exists within the statement that it was declared. That sounds very abstract. That's why we need examples to explain this. Here we see a function eat. We have var variables here. So we have our food variable that contains a value, and we're logging out the food variable to the console. And then we have an if conditional. This is to create a second block, a second statement, and we're saying if food equals pizza, which obviously it will then go into that block statement, and we'll then assign drink or wine to the variable of drink and log out food and drink. And then we'll leave that if conditional, that statement will be outside of the statement, and we'll log out both variables again, or we'll try to log them out. So we run our function here, eat. By the way, functions are something we're gonna look at in the next video. So we run our function, and it means that it's gonna log out pizza, then pizza wine, and pizza wine again. So you can see three console logs. It logs out the first, the second, the third, okay? Now, if outside of that function definition, we try to access food and drink, the variable, it's gonna throw a reference error because it's gonna say, sorry, I have no idea what food and drink are, okay? So those variables live within the context of our eat function. This is with var. It looks a bit differently with let. So we're doing the exact same thing, but this time on the console logs, we're gonna get a crucial difference, because on our third console log, we're gonna get a reference error. Drink is not defined. But wait a minute, I've defined drink in here. So why can't I log it out to the console here? Well, that's the key difference. Now here, side by side, just to demonstrate, our variable drink on the left side in the var example lives within the statement where it was declared, so within the curly brackets of that if statement, but it also can be accessed from outside. That is why the last console log that we see here can log out wine correctly. On the other hand, on the right, we see that our let, this let drink, only lives within that block statement. And as soon as we leave that block statement and we reach our third and last console log, it has no more access to the drink variable, okay? So that's what we mean with the difference in scopes. You could kind of like say that the parent in var has access to the child variable, but with let, that is not the case. The parent would not have access, so the function outside doesn't have access to what has been declared within the if block statement. Second difference, redeclaring. With var variables, we can redeclare them after we initially declared them. That is not the case with let. If we try to do that, we'll receive an error message. Here are examples. On the right side, we see that within our function greet, we have the variable of name. So we're declaring with var the variable of name and assigning Jane as a value to it. Then we're logging that out to the console, and then right beneath that we're saying, we changed our mind, we're gonna store Sarah in name. Now, if we run this function, we will get the following output, greeting you Jane, greeting you Sarah. Why? Because on the line right before console log, we redeclared variable of name and added the value of Sarah to it. What does let do in this situation? Well, obviously when we're writing a function, it lets us do that. But once we run it, then we'll get an error message. And it tells us that the identifier name has already been declared. So it will not let us redeclare that variable name. We cannot store that value Sarah if we write let name equals Sarah. Quiz question for you. How about you answer? What do we really need to store Sarah a name? Obviously, let name equal Sarah won't work, but what would be the correct way to change the value? So not redeclare, but change the value of name when we're working with let? Write it in the comment section below. Third difference, hoisting. Var variables are hoisted or lifted to the top of a function statement. So if we try to access such a variable that is hoisted, we will get back an undefined. Now with let, that's not the case. And by the way, it's also the same for const. So let and const are hoisted but not initialized. So we will receive an error message whenever we try to access that value. Again, what does this mean? Have a look. On the left, we have our greet function, and we're doing something a bit different this time because we're logging out to the console whatever is in name, in the variable of name, although we're defining, or excuse me, declaring our var variable afterwards. So when we run the function, we get greeting you undefined. Why? Well, because it knows that name is there, it's going to be there, it just doesn't know the value when it's logging out to console because the value has not been assigned yet, but it knows about the variable and it just gives it the value of undefined. Now if we try to do the same thing with let, we're going to get a bit of a surprise because it says, reference error, I cannot access name before the initialization. So here it's telling us, sorry, name not initialized, it's not accessible for me, so I'm just going to throw an error message. Okay, so these are the differences between the two. Our next video is all about functions, what they are, how to create them, how to use them, and the variations of functions that exist. I suggest you sign up to this YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any of our JavaScript videos. And if you learned anything today, then please go ahead and leave us a like.